Today I'm going to show you two different ways to do a word-by-word text animation in DaVinci Resolve. And the best part is, both of these techniques can be done within one single text node. Let's get into it. This first technique is going to be a scale-in animation for each word. So each word zooms in one after the other, like this. Now we are going to use the Fusion tab to achieve both of these effects, but if that's a little bit outside your comfort zone, don't disappear just yet, because I've also got something later in the video that could be used in the edit page too. To create our text animation, we're going to use the follower modifier. It's really easy to set up. We just click on our text node, come up to the text box in our inspector window, and right click. And from here we could select follower. And then if you come up and click on the modifiers tab here, you'll be able to see the follower modifier that we've added. Now by default, you'll be on the timing tab, but before we look at this, we're going to jump over to the transform tab. In the transform tab, you're going to see a drop down at the very top, and we want to change this to word. So with that done, that's going to allow us to use the rest of the controls in this section to animate each word. So I'm just going to expand these to show you what I mean. Down at the very bottom, we've got two controls for the size, X and Y, so your width and your height basically, which I'm going to set to 0 just now for both of them. I'll then drag my playhead back to the very start, and we'll set a keyframe on both of these controls. And that's going to make your text disappear just now, but don't worry, that's totally normal. Now, I want each of these words to come in over, say, 10 frames. So we'll go to frame 10, and we'll change these to 1 again. So they're going to go from 0 to full-sized over the course of 10 frames. And if we play that back now, you'll get a sense of what's happening here. All of our words are zooming in individually, but it's all at once. So we're going to jump over to the timing tab of the modifier. At the bottom, you'll see this little delay control here, and that's going to add a delay between the words. The higher the number, the longer the delay. So I'm going to set it to 2, and if I play that back, we'll start to see our word-by-word animation taking shape now. But there's a couple of extra things we could do to make this even better. With the text node selected, if we open up the spline tab and check on the style text animation, we'll see the animation curve for our size parameter that we just set. So again, you can see here it's going from 0 to 1 over 10 frames. And we can adjust the easing of this animation using the handles here, or for quickness, we can highlight them, right click and go to ease. So in here you're going to have a bunch of easing options to choose from. I really like the outback cubic one because it overshoots the animation a little bit, so I'm going to choose that. If I play that back now, you'll see the effect that has on our animation, which is pretty cool. One last thing, if you jump back into the Tools tab of the text node and go along to Settings, we could turn on Motion Blur for the text as well. Hi, sorry to interrupt the video, editor Ryan here. One issue I've been noticing recently is that this thing happens where the text looks like it's been cut off at the edges. Now there is a fix for it. If you go into the layout section of the text node, in here you can change the type from point to frame, and that will fix the issue for you. I'm not really too sure why this is happening. I think it's something that maybe they need to update and resolve, but yeah, that's how you fix it. Okay, back to the video. The cool thing about this is because we used a modifier to create it, you could change the wording of it and it will still work. Which makes it perfect to set up as a custom effect for the edit page, which is exactly what I've done. So if you're not quite comfortable with Fusion yet, but you want to be able to set up some subtitles like these, there's a link in the description for you to download that for free. Okay, now let's have a look at this second animation. As you can see, in this one, the text animates in from a different position, and this could be from right to left, from top to bottom, whatever you please. Unfortunately, this one isn't quite as simple to achieve because, for some reason, and I have no idea why, the transform section of the follower modifier doesn't have any position controls, so we can't just use the same method to reposition the words. No idea at all why it doesn't have that, I really wish it did. One thing you can do though, which is kind of faking it, but it does work, if you have the size follower animation set up, so the one that I just showed you how to do, and you jump back into the tools section of the text node, so not the modifier, but the main controls of the text node, if you go into the transform tab there, you can adjust the pivot control of the text, which will offset the animation in one particular direction and give you sort of the same effect. it's still got that size animation in there, so it's not quite the same as each word moving individually. Thankfully though, there is another method we can use. It's a little bit cumbersome, but I'm going to walk you through it step by step. So again, I'm going to start by setting up a follower modifier. But instead of coming into the transform section, we're going to stay in the timing part and come down to order and select manual curve. And with that selected, you'll see a bunch of new controls appear. So the first thing we'll do is we're going to set our playhead to frame 0 and then hit this keyframe here, delay by character position. And that's going to bring that parameter into the spline editor for us, which we'll come back to in a moment. But for now, we need to decide which frame on the timeline we want each word to start animating in. I want the first word to animate right away at frame 0, then the next at frame 10, and the last at frame 20. So I'm going to highlight the first word interviewer here, and then hit this button here, set first selected character delay. Now with our delay value being at 0 here, that'll ensure that our first word animates in at frame 0. I'll then highlight the second word, set the delay value to 10, and hit the button again. And then again, I'll highlight the next word, set the delay value to 20 this time, and hit the button again. If your sentence is longer, you could just keep doing this over and over until the sentence is complete. And also, just to be clear, you don't have to move the playhead when you're doing this. You're essentially predetermining the frame that each word is going to animate in at when you're using this button here, so no need to move the playhead. But if we have a look now at the spline editor, we'll see this gradual increase over time, which kind of looks like the timing of your animations, but it's not, and you shouldn't confuse it with that. This spline relates to the character selections you've made. So to ensure that we're dealing with each word and not individual characters, we have to highlight all these points here in the spline tab and click this button here to change these to step in. Once you've done that, the modifier is essentially dealing with whole words at that point, so you could just uncheck this and ignore this spline from now on. To add in our animated movement though, we're going to move over to the shading tab of the follower modifier and scroll all the way down to position, which is going to let us animate the position of our words using the offset parameter here. So I'll have these come in over 15 frames from the top of the screen. Now when you set your first keyframe, this path modifier is going to appear, but we don't need to do anything with this, so we're just going to double click on the follower modifier to get back to it. We can then set our second keyframe from there. And I'll add in some easing to that in the spline tab too, just to make sure it looks a little bit slicker, same as last time. And I'm going to set it to outback cubic again on that too. In this particular one, I've also gone into the transform section of the follower modifier just to add a bit of rotation to these as they bounce in, which I think looks pretty cool as it animates in. And then again, just a little bit of motion blur at the end there just to make that look even more slick. This looks pretty good, but believe me, I know how cumbersome and annoying that is to set up. I'm really hoping that Blackmagic makes some updates to the text modifiers in Fusion soon, because animations like this one could just be so much easier to set up. But as of just now, this is the best way to do it and keep it all contained within one text node. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate that. And if you want to learn more text animations in Fusion, definitely give this video a try. And I'll see you in the next one.